So depending on yesterday's session, guys, we saw the row span. Today we will see the call span, right? So you notice one thing, that these both attributes, call span and row span, both of these attributes are implemented in the TED tag only. Remember one thing, all these both attributes will be implemented into the TED tag only. Yeah. So yeah, from yesterday's example, you must have understood about the row spanning. I will give you a few more decorated examples for more practice or brainstorming session. Okay, so today we'll see this example for what? Call span, right? So what is meaning of call span, guys? What do you mean by call span? Yes, what is call span? Why? Don't want to answer. What is call span? Call span means what? Spanning or merging of columns, right? So during merging of columns, you are using that attribute which is called as a call span. So considering this example which is here in front of you, what we are going to do? We are going to draw this table first. So what is the first step? Design the table manually on any paper or somewhere in a graphic, right? So I designed the table. I just took the border 5 for the table. Then this is my first TH, isn't it? This is my first TH, first row. Here I'm going to add what? Month and salary. Am I right? Okay. So this is my first row, first TH, first row, second TH. What is the advantage of taking TH, guys? Why we are going to take TH there? With the help of TH, automatically the text will come in center. Okay. Automatically. The text will appear in the center. Along with that, what is going to happen? It will come as a bold form also. So that is one of the advantage of taking a TH tag, especially it is used for heading, right? Now, so I have how many rows here? First, second, third, and fourth, including TH, right? So this is my first row. I go for second row now. I take a second row, right? Second TR. So in that TR, I take two TDs. One is for January, one is for $100. So after that, I completion my TR, right? Then I go for which row? I go for third row. So in that third row, again, I take two columns or two TD. One is February and another is for $80, right? Now you can see that sum 180. I want to frame this data. So how you are going to frame this data? In this row, right? I am in this row. Fine, I am in this row. Who will tell me the code for framing that call span? How to write code? Who will tell? Yes, anybody? Nobody want to answer today. What's the problem? Am I audible clearly or not? Am I audible clearly to all? Can you hear me properly, all of you? Yes, am I audible to all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then please answer me. Somebody tell me. This is my which row? This is my fourth row. First, second, third, and fourth. This is my fourth row. And here you can see that what I'm doing, guys, I'm merging the columns. No, these are the two columns. I'm not merging rows here. I'm merging the columns. So here what I need to do in this area, I have to take a TD and then I have to take a call span. Okay. So I will open the row first, right? So this is my row, guys. Which row? This is my fourth row, right? In my fourth row, what I'm going to do? I'm going to take a TD. And in that, now what I'm going to do? I'm going to take call span is equals to 2. That's it. Clear to you? Yeah. And then I will put the data saying as sum $180, and then I close my TD and then I close my TR. Is it clear? So in this way, what you're going to do, you're going to span the columns. So this is a very simple example to understand how to combine the columns. Okay. Is it clear? Okay. So at the last, what I will do, I will give you examples at the last. So today, let me explain you a few more things in relation to that. Okay. So let me go back to the code. So this is the code. And yesterday I have given a homework that also I will tell you, okay, for the people, those who have not solved it. I was hoping that everyone would solve it, at least those who have computers at home. for them it was compulsory, right? You should solve that compulsorily if you have any source of doing that. Let me explain you that code. I'm just opening that code. Okay, so this is my screen, notepad here. I have taken homework, right? Homework.html, that is yesterday's code. So yesterday's code, guys, see what I did. I have even not closed HTML and body, and then I executed that and I found it that it is possible to run the code. Why? Because it is HTML, right? So already I have shared, and this is my code. I have taken as value 1, value 2, value 3. Okay, I will just run it for you and will show you how I got the output of that homework, right? So this is what I got. I will just share the screen. Okay, so in this way I took it. I took it as column 1, column 2, and column 3. And then I took it as value 1.1, 1.2, and 1.3. In this way I have taken, okay? So code I will share you, or you can refer the same code that was shared by few students in yesterday, right? So that codes can also do, right? Now we'll go for another code, that is the call span, right? So in call span, okay, just see here, I have taken first HTML, okay? Then I have taken a body tag, as usual, you know that, right? Okay, I have taken HTML, I have taken a body tag, then I have taken table border is equals to 5. Okay, let me draw that for you. I know that you have understood, but once again, let us go through the code. Okay, so this is my table whose border is 5. Then the second thing that I can notice here is the first row. In that first row, what happens is your month and salary appears, right? Then after closing that TR, we are opening the second column. In that second column, you can see again two cells are there. One is January and second is $100, right? Then close that TR and then we are going for February and then we are going for $80. My third row and the third cell, right? And what happens with the last? I have TD call span is equals to 2. So when I take it, what is going to happen, guys? This portion, this entire portion, what I have, it is merged. Okay, that is nothing but the call span. Okay, so just we'll execute this code. So this is your call span. All right, so in this way, I can notice that the output is going to appear. Month savings, January $80, February, okay, then January $100, Feb 80, and sum is $180. So you can see that the cell spacing and cell padding here is default, right? I'm not using other attributes of table. Only we are using what border is equals to 5. We are not using any cell spacing and cell padding. What is cell spacing, guys? The spacing, this spacing between the cells is cell spacing. What is cell padding? The gap between the contents and the border or the cell area. The gap between the contents and the cell is cell padding. You can also apply those features. You can apply other features like table align is equal to center, okay? You can apply table text. So many another features you can try and apply, okay? So I will also show you how to apply attributes to the table. Before going to that, I want to discuss one important question, that is question number 28, okay? So take two homeworks, guys, okay? I will give you homework first and then we will go for 28th question. So what is the homework? You have to span the row, okay? First one is for call span, okay? So this is my table. I have something like this. Suppose I have three columns, right? Yeah, or what I'll do. First, I will draw one row here, okay? Then I have got a second row here, right? And then what I'm going to do, this portion I'm going to take, right? And then I'm going to take like this. Okay, so this is your first homework, guys, right? So you have to use what here, which attribute you're going to use, which attribute you need to use, what is spanned here, what is merged, What is merged here, guys? This portion.
Both row and
column. Both row and column. See, this area is merged. Isn't it? This area is merged. Yes. So can you tell me what is merged? We can see that how many columns are merged? Two columns and two rows. Isn't it? Yeah, two columns and two rows. So I think this will be a bit difficult for you. You first try this one. Just try this one, which would be easy for you, right? Okay. And then what we'll do? We'll go for the tough one. Just try this, right? Try this. Take down this format and try for this one. Okay. All right. This is for spanning the columns, right? So after trying this, what you do, one more homework I will give you. Okay, so I'll clear it. I'll just give 2 minutes for you, draw it down, okay? And then I'll give you one more homework, guys. Okay, so what you have to do now? Okay, take a table. Okay, and then this is your first row, right? And this is your second row, okay? Second row. And then we have, suppose, one column over here, right? And we have a second column over here, right? We have a second column over here, right? Fine. So now just see, how will you write code for this? So here you can see which portion is combined, guys. This portion, whatever you see, this area, in that how many columns are there? Okay, how many columns are there or how many rows are there? You have to think. Right, and try to write code for this. Okay, will you do that? Will you try? Yes, will you try, guys? Okay, just try the code, right? So this, take it as a homework. So now what we'll do, we'll go to another few attributes. Okay, now once when I want to apply, guys, once when I want to apply some changes to this, okay, for example, suppose I want to apply some changes related to font, okay, or I want to make different color for different row. So suppose if I take a font tag here, right? So what we'll do, first I will take table align, okay, table align is equals to, I will take as a center, right? Then I will take table text is equals to, for example, I will take it as red, huh? And I will save the changes, okay, we will rerun the code. Okay, so you can see here, the code is executed, right? So in this way, the code is executed, okay? So why the text is not applicable here, anybody? Why the text is not applicable? Because text is not an attribute of a table tag, okay? It is not an attribute of table tag. It is an attribute of what? Body, right? So when you want to put a text, it is applicable for the body tag. Text is not an attribute, okay? Text is not an attribute of table tag. It means you cannot take their what? Text as an attribute of table tag. How many attributes are there? Already I have shown you, right? So for that reason, if I want to apply some font, what I can do? I have to take a font tag, okay? I have to take a font tag, right? Font color is equals to red. So when I take a font tag, what is going to happen? So I will just save the file, okay? And then what you do, you close the font tag until where you want to apply, okay? You just close the font tag. Okay, so is the output screen visible to all of you? Is the output screen visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. See, for call span also, that feature, whatever red I'm taking, no, it is not getting applied. Can you find out what is the error here? Yes, can you find out what is the error? We have taken correctly, right? I have taken font color is equals to red. Then I'm also closing what? The table tag. I'm also closing the font tag. But still, it is not showing me. Can you tell me what might be the error? Yes, anyone? What might be the error? Why it is not taking color? Yes. What might be the error? Who will tell? Do you think it is an error? We have coded correctly, right? There is no problem with the code. Actually, when I run this code, what should happen, guys? It should take a font color for the table contents as red. But again, what is happening for a table when you want to apply the color? For a table content, when you want to apply the color, what you have to do? You have to take font tag within the table. Just we will try this, okay? So I will cut it from here and I will just take it inside the table tag, okay? I will just take it inside the table tag. Are you getting that? So this font where you have to close inside the table tag. Now let me check whether it is going to run or whether the changes are applied or not, okay? So can you see still the changes are not applied? Okay, so I'll just rerun the code once again. Actually, it should get applied here. Okay, so font font color is equals to red. Okay, we are taking all the values correctly. Let me check with another feature. Okay, so what we'll do, body. Let us go to body. We will take body text is equals to red. Okay. Now, where is my font tag? We need to remove that font tag here. Okay. Just we'll save the changes. And once again, we will go back and see whether this property is going to work, right? What is the name of our file, guys? Yes. What is the name of our file? Okay. So you can see here, when I take it in a body tag, right? When I take it in a body tag, the font is getting applied to all the rows and all the columns. So when I want to apply a different font to different row and different cell, what you have to do, you have to take font tag for that specific row. So row wise, what you have to do, you have to take the font. Let me try that one. So now by default, the red font is there. That red font is applicable for all because I have taken that into the body. Now what I will do for this row, I will take one font. So font, C-O-L-O-R, color, I will take blue. Let me check how it is going to work for each row. So before closing the row, what I will do, guys, I will just close here my font tag. Okay. And I will save the file and I will try to rerun my code. Okay, so when I try to rerun my code here, guys, so I can see that there are still some issues it is showing when it comes to the font. When we want to apply what font to a particular row or when we want to apply font to the particular cell. Okay, so there are certain things which do not work with the table tag. So that is one of the reason we have to go for what, guys? A CSS, right? So what is CSS? CSS is nothing but it is called as what? Cascaded style sheets, right? We have something called as what? Cascaded style sheets, right? Now, let me go into more inner area to check like whether I can apply within each cell, right? So I will take font color is equals to blue. So now what I'm doing, guys, I'm going cell wise, right? I have gone into the cell. So I'm going row wise initially. Now I'm trying to apply that feature for a particular row, right? So what I will do within this row, I will just try to close my font tag. Okay. So I'm going now row wise or I'm going now column wise. Now let me see whether this feature is going to work or not. Okay. So remember one thing, guys, always whatever changes you are doing, compulsorily that changes must be saved, right? So otherwise, sometimes if the changes are not saved, it may show some error, right? Okay. But definitely, the file is already open. Okay, so what I'll do, I'll follow another method, that is Alt+F+S, right? Okay. So students, those who have logged in, right? Now, those who have logged in just now, I want all of you to enter your details correctly, right? I can see students are logging in now, okay? So please enter your details correctly, right? All right. So now what I'll do again, I'll try to open that file, guys, and let us see what changes are applied. So can you see that now the changes have got applied? I have applied what blue to that particular column or particular TH. So this is one problem when it comes with the table tag. If you want multicolor content into the table, then what you have to do, you have to go row wise and column wise or data wise. You cannot apply using body tag or font tag commonly to the contents of the table. When you want to play with the graphics into the table, what you have to do, you have to take separate font tag everywhere. You have to take a separate font tag for this row or the contents of this row. Again, for this row, what you have to take, you have to take another font tag, or for the cells, you have to take another font tag. So playing with the font color combinations is difficult in the table tag. So this is one of the drawback of HTML. You can apply some features, okay, to the entire contents, you can apply the same features. But when it comes to table tag, form tag, these type of problems you will face when you want to apply different types of graphics or different types of text color to each combination of row and column. So for that reason, guys, we are going for one more feature of web programming language, which is called as CSS, that we will study in the next class. So using CSS, the code is more modified, and that modified code, what we can do is we can just create some more coding, some more code we have to write so that you can apply a set of attributes to any of the tags, right? So now what I'll do, I'll just again try to put some attributes in the code. Okay, I'll just try to put some attributes in Notepad again. Yes, so what I will do, I have taken font color blue, right? So I will remove the closing from here, and what I will do, I will just close it here. Okay, I will close at the end of the another th, right? So I will just close it here, and then I will save it. Now let me rerun for you. Let me see what changes are applied, right? Let me rerun. I will just go back to the file. First, the procedure of saving the file must be correct, okay? Otherwise, it will show the error. And I'm applying XHTML, guys, okay? So more strict rules are here, I can see in XHTML, okay? If I take simple HTML, it is just a little bit easier to run with the code. But when I'm working with XHTML, compulsorily what you have to do, you have to follow certain rules and regulations here. So still you can see that some features are not applied to the second heading here. Okay, still some features are not applied here. So what you have to do, guys, so this font tag, what you are applying, you have to go row wise. Okay, so complete a font tag here, then open one more font tag here. Okay, F-O-N-T, font, C-O-L-O-R, color is equals to what color you want me to take. I'll take green, okay, for example, right, green. And then what I will do, I will just close the font tag here, okay? I'll just make a note to close a font tag here, okay? Now you save the changes, right? Then after saving the changes, when you go back and just rerun the code, see, make a note, you're saving the changes simultaneously, okay? Then go to call span, right? So we can see that green color is not getting applied. I think there is some problem with the code. The code is correct, guys. Okay, yeah, see here, there's a spelling.
Color spelling.
Yes, yes, thank you. The color spelling mistake is there, right? So just make a note. Okay, so if you make any spelling mistakes also, you can see that there will be some issues, okay? So now what I'll do, I'll rerun the code, fine? So now you just note that the colors have appeared, right? So in this way, today's assignment will be, you have to make a different file where you can see that different types of fonts and different types of color combination, different types of sizes are in front of you, okay? So what I will do, I will give you one homework here. And in that homework, what you have to do is, I will tell you that. So is it clear about how to apply font for different rows and different columns? Is it clear? So suppose now I will remove this body text, right? I will remove this body text. Fine. So I told you that in table, you cannot put what text attribute, right? It will take, but it will not show for execution, right? Now one attribute is there. I can take BG color if you want. Okay, let me try this attribute for table tag for you people. Okay. So I have saved the file. Just I will go back and I will try to run the file. Okay. So that red has disappeared because I have removed what body? I have removed the body text is equals to red, right? So in this way, you can use some colors with the tables. Right? This is the way. One thing is that it is like for columns and rows, whatever you are using, it is very strict when it comes to the font. Fine. So I will just remove this BG color because it is not so clearly visible for you people, right? Now, what else attributes you can see here? Suppose let us try for the row. Is it clear where you can apply and where you cannot apply, right? So suppose if I want to apply one feature for this row, suppose if I want to apply contents for this row, right? Font color is equals to, suppose I will take blue, right? And then what I will do before closing this row, I will try to cover it here. I will just try to apply all these fonts over here. And let me see how it is going to work, right? Okay. So after saving, what I will do, again, I will go to my file and then again, I will try to rerun the code. Okay. So you can see that even though I had applied in that row, it is not getting applicable to the second row. Is it clear? It is not getting applicable to this second row, even though I'm using it for the row. So where you have to add the font tag, if you want to apply to this January and dollar, you have to exactly apply before the TD tag. Okay. You have to exactly apply that before the TD tag. For example, let me make some changes back again. Right. So what I'll do, I'll just remove this color blue from here and I'll just put it inside this TD. Okay. I'll just put it inside the TD and then I will close that font tag here. Okay. After applying to the content, I will close it here. Right. So here again, I will take one more font tag. Suppose I will take it in the red. I will take it as a red. Right. And then I have to close this TD at the back, guys. Right. After completion of the font, I have to close that TD tag, right? Now save the changes. See, while saving here, you can see blue and green color variation into the title bar. If it is red, it means the changes have not saved. So when you save it for like correctly, it will change its color into blue, okay? This option is disabled because it is saved now. Now let me run the code again and let me see what changes are applied to my code. Did you get that? So in this way, what I have to do, I have to go on applying the color features to each of my data cell, each of my combination of columns. So this is one of the problem which comes when I want to play with different colors and different text inside some tags. So what is the main problem here? Some attributes, okay? Some attributes will not work. Okay, some attribute will not work in other tags, right? Yeah. So every tag has got its own attributes, right? We can use some attributes in other tags also, but we cannot use what font, okay? We cannot use or deal with the font when it comes to what, guys? The combination of this table tag. Is it clear? Okay. So can I give you one homework, guys? Okay. So you take same homework and what you do here is try to apply with your own font and own color and share me the code. Will you do that? If it is possible for you to do with the notepad, share me the notepad. If it is possible, to do and write it and share, you can share me in that also. Okay. So hope you will do that. Now, one more question number 28, I will show you. And depending on that, try to solve it. Okay. So I will show you that. All right, see, this is question number 28 here. Already I have shared to you this in the notes. So this is a question which has appeared in the question paper for your seniors, right? But I thought of giving this as a challenge to you and try to write the code for this. First, write the code and then what you do, just go through the source that I have shared you. Okay, will you do that, all of you? First, what you do the designing, right? After designing, what you do, see how many rows are there, how many columns are there, and where to merge the columns, how many number of columns and how many number of rows you have to merge. Okay, so try to solve this. I will not explain you this in the coming classes. We will see when I do the revision class. Okay, because in the next class, I want to share you about list tag. Okay, once when I take an extra class, I will explain you this code. So you try to solve the code, right? All right. Yeah. So any queries are there, guys, for today's class? Yes, any queries are there? No queries. Okay. So those who have not yet entered the attendance, please put your attendance in the chat box. I will save your attendance. All right, guys. So we'll see if possible. Saturday I'm free. I will take an extra class. We'll try to solve this code. Otherwise, we'll do that on Monday. So till then, keep writing all your this one notes. Okay. Okay, then.